I start when I was 5 years old, and okay, football was my whole life. When I was a kid, I always liked to play football with friends also. And then I start with a small team next to my city called Gošk Castro Gomilica. And there I started like few years, and then I moved to bigger club in Split to play for Dalmatinac. It was like kind of friendly club with the Hajduk Split, and through there I go to Hajduk Split when I was really young, and all my career I played there. Till I gone to Belgium. My father was really close with the football, and also he finished school, and he helped me the most about football, to understanding it, and guide me when I was young, to teach me a lot about it. Also, my mother was a handball player, and my older sister too.
Okay, and your twin sister?
My twin sister, she is special. Yeah, she wasn't good in sport, but you know, she tried to sing, and she works on the airport. But it's really amazing to have a twin sister, deep connection with her, and she helped me a lot in my life. I had like my first preseason for the first team when I was like 16 years. I also played some friendly games, but not official ones. And when I was 17, then I started to play like official games and you know, be part of something.
When you were 18, you had occasion to play against Inter Milan in this Europa League qualifications. How do you remember this day?
Yeah,
when you won at San Siro?
Yeah, I remember it very well. You know, it was an amazing game. Also, unlucky for us that we lost first game at home 3-0, and nobody expect from us that we can beat them at San Siro, but it happened.
I read somewhere that when you came back to Croatia, you were welcomed like a heroes, even though you lost this two games.
Yeah, this club, they have the best fans in the country, and really if you have good results against good teams, that's they support you, and really it was really glad to feel it after that game.
In this game you played as defensive midfielder, as I checked.
I played like 2-3 different positions. You know, first half I was like a more midfielder and maybe winger, I don't know. And the second half he pulled me back like a center back.
How was it to such a young guy to play against players like Zanetti in the central midfield or Sneijder in Inter Milan?
You know, for us, you know, like when you cannot lose anything, you just give yourself, you give your heart on the pitch, and then what happens, you know. And in that time, we played a really good game, and everybody was happy about that. In that time, I feel that it's the right time to try myself in another club, in another country, and then I get a call from Ostende, and I see the project of the club and everything, and that's I liked, and that's the club goes next years. That we were really growing up from the really small club. We were growing up till the Europe and till the final cup game, and you know, I'm very proud that what we did there.
You chose Belgium, even though I read somewhere that you have propositions from other countries. You chose Belgium.
Yes.
Why?
You know, like my manager, you know, we speak a lot. What is a good step for me? And in that time, I think it was really good step for me, because I need to step to grow up, not to jump, you know. That's why I choose that club.
You said that you were growing up like as a club, and that's what happened. But I'm wondering how you remember your first game in Ostende versus Kortrijk.
Yeah, you know, like I couldn't speak the language too, and it was difficult for me. You know, it was like a first game after 1 week I came. We had like a small pre-season, like 5 days, and then directly the competition starts. And Kortrijk was really good team. And our team in that time, like last 6 months, we didn't have any goals because we stayed in the league. And for me, it was like, okay, let's just play the game, but it wasn't that good. And then I start to, you know, to grow up. And after 6 months, the new coach knew, so many new players came, and then everything start from zero, and then start really good for that team. You know, I come to prove myself. Everywhere I come, I like to prove myself like a player, like a person. And for me, the only goal was that to work hard and to try to give my best, to that the people can see that I'm a very good player, and they can be happy that I'm playing there. And after, of course, after I need some time to prove it, and after I prove it very well.
In Ostende, you achieved more than everybody, I guess, supposed you can achieve in such a small club for
yeah, and in that time I came to the club, and the club, you know, like they couldn't stay 2 years in a row in the first division, and then we stay in the first division. Everybody was happy, but I say a lot of 10th place, everybody's happy, all that. But after, you know, after year by year, you know, like we grow up, we play playoff once, two seasons in a row, final cup, European game. It was really amazing.
The one thing in Ostende, this free kick goal you scored. I heard there is some story with team captain behind this goal. What's that?
Not that big story, you know, like he's the tough guy. When he wanted to take free kick, he was the captain. And everybody needs to respect that, but you know, in that time, I felt like it's real time, because I train a lot about that, and I knew that I can score it, and I had really good feeling before that kick, and he allowed me.
It was only one free kick goal you scored?
Yeah, it's only one, but I didn't shoot that lot. Maybe two more times. If you look at the history, it's the biggest club, but for the moment, okay, they are struggling. That's normal. And but you know, I have also had a proposal, but I picked that club because I always dream about trophies, and I know that club can give me the way to get those trophies in my career. And then in the end, it was like opposite, and what you can say. First 2 months was incredible. Yeah. We won almost all the games, and then in one moment it was like I don't know how to call it, but like a blackout, you know, for the whole team. Not, and you know, like then we finished like fourth, and was like incredible bad season for all of them. But you know, like it was like also so many new players in the team, you know, still needs time to connect all of them together, you know, to try to function, but didn't. And then they last couple of years, they change a lot of players, they try everything, but still there is no result.
There were a lot of coach changes that as well, and one of these coaches was Vincent Kompany. You met him at Anderlecht.
Yes.
Yeah, how was to work with still quite a young guy for a coach, but one of the Belgium legends, may I say.
Yeah, it was a pleasure to train with him and to learn so many things about football. And he has like, maybe he's not that experienced, but his knowledge is high. And I know that he knows what he's doing, with the team, but still needs time.
At the time when you transferred from Ostende to Anderlecht, it was the time when you started playing in national team, something like
yes,
this.
Yes.
And how was about this World Cup 2018? Because you were somewhere near to this Croatia team in this World Cup.
Yeah, but near, you know, like we are really, really good squad for the national team, and it's kind of difficult to find a place for the World Cup, and I didn't find mine, but I hope in the future I will find the place for myself.
You started playing in national team right after the World Cup in 2018. You
yeah.
played 3 games, and all of them as the left defender.
Left back.
Yeah. How it happened that
you know, like in our national team, there is so many good players on the central defender, and it's with experience, with so many games in the feet, and it's difficult to step before them, you know. But the national team in that time has a problem on the left side, and then I step in 3 games, and I am happy I played good there. And it was difficult period for me because, you know, like I had some other solutions, and I had also like a small fight with the club. And then in the end, I couldn't stay, you know. It was like last week of the transfer door, and I need to like just pick where I will be happy to play football, you know. Because I'm not happy when I'm sitting on the bench, or every player is happy to play and enjoying the game. That's why I decided just to move to find myself somewhere and to play.
And how was it for you in Spain?
Yeah, was it good? You know, unlucky for me, I had like first I arrived late because they already start like 5-6 games, and then I play like 2 games good, and I get like small injury of ankle, and I need some time to come back. And after we play really good, but unlucky Corona cut us off.
Yeah, Corona happened when you were in Spain. You stayed whole this lockdown time in Spain by yourself.
Yes.
How was it? It must have been tough.
It's tough for everybody, I think. You know, like this time of year, it's really difficult for everybody. But you need to just push forward and wait.
Next step is Lech Poznań here. And what can you say about your experience from here after these first few weeks?
But you know, I'm happy to come here, and I know this is a team with high quality, and I know that in next weeks we're gonna show that.